Titanic's grand staircase was an improvement on Olympics, and now Britannic's staircase surely improves on Titanic. Now, let's see if we can't spot any differences. I believe I've seen this room in a moving picture once. That's loud. I don't like loud things. Cabins are quite a priority for them on this ship. I've seen most first-class cabins getting enlarged, while White Star is squeezing additional ones in wherever they can. I understand every one of these cabins forward have direct access to their own washrooms. That's quite an advancement from previous ships, even from Titanic, even from my own flat. Since things hit a crescendo and rapid diminuendo with Claire, I've had to share latrines with that greasy Mr. Tundry and his band of urchins. I will not put up with their privy pinches any longer. White Star Line is really outdoing themselves with regards to passenger service. In addition to the inquiry office on the deck below, passengers have what appears to be their very own post office right here on B deck. They've already begun preparing to dismantle the passenger accommodations. Won't be long now until this ship is bare steel and hit a ceiling. Here's a stack of memories I should probably begin repressing. They've gutted it. The pipe organ, the beautiful wood paneling, the questionable blue flooring. The one comfort is that it's being kept safe from the Hun's brutish fist. Oh, here's a stack of memories I should probably begin repressing. Gallipoli and the Dardanelles campaign. What a disaster that was. What is the meaning of all these ropes everywhere? We're an extra deck down from the Regal Suite. I wonder who'd be occupying this cabin. Wounded officers, RAMC, perhaps the nurse matron, or Mr. Robin Darcy. Frankly, a wonder to see how such a palace and triumph of appointment could be so rapidly turned over into an efficient medical facility supporting the greatest war we've ever known. One could get lost in their own cabin on this ship. Robin, now it's time for you to have some real fun. Glad to see the pool is still being used. The Britannic deserves some joy in these dark years. Maybe I can get some laps in before the ship departs for Lemnos. Now, the real question is, how did I end up here? There I was in Naples, minding my own business, and I see a group of nurses disembark from a motor launch. And there, beyond the nurses, I see her. My girl, the Britannic. I'd toured her in Belfast before she was converted into a hospital. I had to see what the war did to her. I took the motor launch, bumped the pier a few times, and here I am. Now, question two. Did I tie up the motor launch to the ship before I climbed the ladder?